Hello and welcome to this, the third week of the course on Oracle Jet. At the start of this, the third week, you should have an understanding of the kinds of enterprise problems that Jet helps solve. You should also have a basic understanding of the libraries underpinning Jet, such as require and knockout. You should have done quite a bit of coding in NetBeans IDE or in another tool while getting comfortable with the creation of Jet applications. You've learned about Jet modules and you've worked with the Jet cookbook using a variety of Jet components. With that background, you are ready to continue with the third week of the course on Oracle Jet. The theme of this, the third week of the course on Jet, is to learn how to connect with the world around Jet. Jet explicitly and intentionally is an open client architecture, meaning that you should be able to incorporate other libraries and technologies into your Jet applications without too much work. In particular, during this week's lesson, you'll be introduced to code reuse and component-based development via Oracle Jet's Composite Component Architecture, while you'll also see how Jet connects to Oracle Cloud Services. You'll learn about the full development cycle around Jet, that is, you'll learn about technologies for building, testing, and deployment of Jet applications. You'll wrap up the week by dealing with the remaining enterprise-level challenges that you're likely to face and how Jet handles them, such as the challenges of internationalization, accessibility, and security. By the end of this lesson, you will have explored the Jet ecosystem and have a good understanding of the related technologies. Many frameworks, libraries, and toolkits have as an aim to enable you to do component-based development. But what do we mean by a component? Generically, a component is a piece of code with a well-defined set of properties, methods, and events. And the benefit of component-based development is to enable you to encapsulate complexity, isolate functionality, simplify consumption of code and reuse, and the standardization of component-based development enables you to promote the concept of an ecosystem by a sharing of code between different applications, between different teams, between different organizations, and so on. How does the concept of a component map to the terminology that you have learned so far? Throughout this course, you have learned about Oracle Jet modules and Oracle Jet components. In this part, we're going to introduce a new term, and that is composite components. Composite components map to the idea of a component in component-based development. Composite components in Jet enable component-based development via the creation of reusable components that you put together by means of JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. The related standard in the JavaScript ecosystem is that of the W3C Web Component Standard. The composite component architecture that you are going to be introduced to in this part is Oracle's implementation of the Web Component Standard in the context of Oracle Jet. Jet introduces composite components as reusable pieces of UI that can be embedded as custom HTML elements and can be composed of other composites, Jet components, HTML, JavaScript, and/or CSS. Take a look at the Oracle Jet cookbook, where there is a dedicated section for composite components in the frameworks part of the cookbook to learn more about composite components in detail. Notice that each Oracle Jet composite component has a loader.js file which combines the various files together that compose the component and defines a custom element that can then be embedded inside one of your Oracle Jet modules. This is how custom elements are defined in Oracle Jet applications. The Oracle Jet Developer Guide has an entire chapter dedicated to understanding and creating and using composite components. The chapter takes you through the entire process of how composite components are constructed, provides a complete code example that you can follow step by step throughout the developer guide chapter, shows you how to, once you have created the composite component, embed it inside of a page, and also gives you tips and tricks for testing your composite components. In short, the composite component architecture enables you to create web component-based CCA components. CCA components enable you to share functionality between different JET applications. It also enables Oracle Cloud products to be extended. You will see one example of this in the next part of the course, where the Visual Builder Cloud service will be extended by means of a CCA component created in JET. CCA components are fundamental to the JET architecture, and if we were to re-architect this course from scratch, we would place a far larger focus on this specific topic. In this part of the course, you have been introduced to the themes and the requirements for the third lesson, the final lesson of the course. In particular, we are focused on CCA components, and your homework task is to take a look at the developer guide and at the cookbook to implement your first CCA component and to share it with one of your colleagues. With that, we thank you as always for taking part in the course and see you in the next part.